Welcome to a lesson on voting fairness criteria. In this lesson, we'll define four voting fairness criteria and also define Arrow's impossibility theorem. Fairness is often subjective. However, the following four fairness criteria must be met for a fair voting system. Number one, if a candidate receives a majority of first place votes, that candidate should be the winner. This is called the majority criterion. Number two, if a candidate is preferred in every one-to-one comparison with the other choices, that choice should be the winner. This is called the Condorcet criterion. Number three, if voters change their votes to increase the preference for a candidate, it should not harm that candidate's chances of winning. This is called the Monotonicity criterion. And number four, if a non-winning choice is removed from the ballot, it should not change the winner of the election. This is called the independence of irrelevant alternatives criterion. So we might be thinking to ourselves, is there a voting system that will satisfy all four of these fairness criteria? And this leads us to Arrow's impossibility theorem, which states that no voting system can satisfy all four fairness criteria in all cases. And looking at this preference table, here's an example where there's no voting system that will satisfy all four fairness criteria. Notice each of the four rankings receives 10 votes, and we have a total of 40 voters. Notice that no candidate has a majority, where each candidate has 10 first choice votes, leading to 25% of the total votes. Also notice, if we do a one-to-one comparison, no candidate wins in every one-to-one comparison. So no candidate has a majority, there's no Condorcet winner, and in fact, regardless of the candidate, 3/4 of the voters prefer someone else. And when this occurs, this is called Condorcet's voting paradox. So though no voting system can satisfy all the fairness criteria at all times, some voting systems are better than others in some situations. We can only hope that those in power will pick the voting method that is most fair based upon the type of election. But this does lead to an important and interesting discussion on what voting method should be used in specific elections. I hope you found this helpful.